Hey guys, welcome back to my kitchen. My name is David. This is another episode of Cook It Your Damn Self. This is another D-Crew production. So tonight we're going to be making chicken parmesan, and we're also going to be making some garlic mashed potatoes to go with that. We also are going to have some fresh green beans and maybe a cold dose and some Riesling wine. I don't know. Anyways, why don't we get started? We've got our chicken here, and what we're going to do is we're going to stuff it with some pancetta bacon. I was going to say cheese, but it's bacon. And the pancetta is an Italian bacon. It's kind of cured and salted. And instead of it being smoked like most American bacons, it is dried. And let me see. I'm going to turn this around so you can see. I don't want to stuff it too much, but we've also putting a little bit of Fontana cheese in there. And what we're going to do is we're going to dip it in our egg wash here, just so that we can get our breadcrumbs to stick. And actually, it's not breadcrumbs, it is a butter cracker, one of these Keebler club crackers. It's got a little bit of salt and pepper. We've got some Italian seasoning, and then we also put fresh grated Parmesan cheese in that. And what we're gonna do is just gonna make sure that's coated so that when it bakes up, it's gonna be nice and crispy. And I'm going to go ahead and put that in there. So what we're going to do is we're going to have our oven preheating at 350. And so we're going to pop that in. And when we come back, because we're going to take a short break here in a second, our chicken should be ready. Oh, hold on a second. This isn't perfect. I wanted to put a little bit of lemon juice on top of that, actually. Sorry. I just want to have that lemony flavor on top of that as well. Just a little bit of lemon juice. All right, so like I said, we have our oven preheated at 350. We're going to put this in for about 30 minutes or so, and we're going to check on it. And when we come back, we're going to start our garlic mashed potatoes. We have them already boiling up here. We're going to take those off. We're going to mash them up. We're going to add our garlic, a little bit of heavy whipping cream, and then we're going to start our green beans. So everything's going to be really good for dinner tonight. So we'll see you in about 2 seconds. Welcome back, guys. We're going to go ahead and get the mashed potatoes ready. So let me go ahead and grab my pot holder here. We're going to drain these. And we've had these boiling for a while here so we can get them nice and mashed up in a second. Get the steam out. Oh my god. And we're going to pop those back into our pot here. And I think one of the cooks that I've seen on TV, Mr. Flay, said to put them back on the stove for a little bit so you can burn off that extra water. You don't really want runny potatoes. And I'm not very patient, so I'm going to take that back to an off. What we're going to do is we're going to add some garlic to that. And let me say about 2 spoonfuls. Then we're going to get some butter. And we're going to add that to our potatoes while they're hot. I don't know if that looks like a lot of butter, but I like mine to be very buttery. And so that, and we're going to add a little bit of heavy whipping cream so they get that creamy flavor. Not too much, because like I said, you don't want them to be too runny. And there wasn't that much in there anyway, so. All right, let's get back. Let me get my masher. Masher that in there. This is not scripted, folks. We're going off the top of our heads here now. We're just going to go ahead and mash these up. And that would be our fresh garlic mashed potatoes. And they are a little bit of rough, but they'll get a little solid once we get to eating here. And I like to use the little baby reds. I don't know. They just seem to cook faster rather than like the russet potatoes. And I like to keep them in my kitchen so that if I want to like make something else like an omelet, you can just slice it up real quick and they cook fast. And what we're going to do is Jules wanted the little cheesy potato, so we're going to add some of this Parmesan as well. So we're going to move on to the next thing. We're going to get our green beans going. And I need Jules to back it up a little bit. And we've got my pan on like a medium heat here. Just going to add some butter. Butter makes everything better, so here you go. I think it was a little too hot, but oh well. Now I'm using fresh green beans here. I guess I could have bought the ones in the can, but I just like the clean flavor. And you know, this is probably not as healthy as I could make it sound to be, but we're just going to throw these in here. And we're just going to let that saute for a little bit. Hot, hot, hot. And add a little bit of salt. Not too much. Using some salt there. Alright. So while we've got this going, we're still waiting for the chicken to come out. And we're just going to let that saute for a little bit. When you come back, in a couple of seconds, we're going to have everything plated up. The chicken should be ready. And we'll see you about that time. Alright, guys? Alright, so we're back. We plated up our food. We took our chicken out of the oven, and this is what the end result is. So, looks pretty good. So, me and Jules are going to scarf this stuff down, and we're going to maybe have a cold dose right here, or we're going to also have some Riesling. I think the Riesling would be the better choice. We've got some garlic toast going here, and I mentioned this before, but this garlic toast right here, you have it in your freezer. You can use it for whatever reason. You could, no, don't do that. there. The garlic toast, it's just a good idea to have. You can just throw a couple slices on a pan or put it in the oven, heat it up, and you're ready to go. And I think that's about it. So if you have any questions, please feel free to email me at pansonn@live.com or go find me at YouTube or my Facebook page. Once again, I'd like to thank you for stopping by again. This has been Cook It Your Damn Self. My name is David. Remember, guys, life can be fun if you let it. We'll see you next time, guys. Good night. I know. To take me home.